You know what I don't get in movies and games? Nobody gets tired. I know it sounds petty and ridiculous, but it's something that bothers me. Think of the movies you've watched or the games you played where the hero takes a weekend trip through hell and high water. Could they have survived that had they had a realistic human cardiovascular and circulatory system? In this video on Nerd Explains, I'll show you why physical fatigue is the most underrepresented danger in movies and games. Whether it's Spartacus slashing down Romans, Kyle Crane parkouring from zombies in Dying Light, or John Wick gun-fuing hitmen, exhaustion will suck the fight out of them all the same. Battles require stamina, the same as skill. Ironically, Zombieland points this out with their number one rule, cardio. Apocalypses are exhausting. Let's take a look at some movies and games. Right before we jump in though, if you find these types of videos entertaining, consider clicking the like and subscribe buttons, as it really does help me to make more. Think of the beginning of 28 Weeks Later, where the house gets swarmed and he runs for the boat with zombies sprinting at him. Put yourself in his shoes. Just imagine the fear. With your heart pounding, you're desperately trying to make your legs and arms move as fast as possible. You can barely get enough oxygen in your lungs, and your legs are on fire, and those fucking things keep getting closer. You feel yourself slowing down, and you don't know if you can make it. You mentally start breaking down because your body can't keep this pace up, and you still aren't to the boat yet. You can't stop, you can't catch your breath, or you'll be ripped apart. You force your arms and legs to swing faster while your eyes water with fear. I like this scene because it shows that exhaustion is so important in making the movie relatable. Because had you been in that situation, that's your biggest vulnerability. It wasn't about impeccable form or highly developed skills or some magical force. It was the human body being pushed to its limits, and had the boat been 50 yards further, he might have run out of breath and been killed. Medieval war is exceptionally demanding, wielding swords and shields and slashing against hordes of barbarians. Your character, Marius Titus, is repeatedly solo fighting groups of enemies. Even if you have the skill, you are fighting not just multiple attackers, but multiple cardiovascular systems. If by some miracle you make it out of that alive, you're going to be completely physically drained. Spartacus was seemingly inexhaustible, but even for a hero, realistically, you're at least going to start slowing down after fighting 5 to 10 trained enemy soldiers, which will make you vulnerable. Marius Titus is also outfitted in tons of armor plating, carrying a sword, a shield, and a helmet. I looked up the weight of a Roman soldier's gear, and that's up to 100 pounds you're moving, swinging, and blocking with. The strength and cardio required for a battle is unreal. It just further emphasizes the suspension of disbelief needed to watch heroes absolutely wreck their way through lines of enemy troops from dawn to dusk, only to be slightly out of breath. Atomic Blonde, probably one of the greatest fight scenes I've seen, because they recognize that the battle isn't just against your enemy, but the amount of fight you have in yourself. Put yourself in her shoes. You're on the run escorting a VIP, fighting multiple stronger attackers in hand-to-hand combat. Hand-to-hand combat is ridiculously tiring. Look at UFC fighting. These are the absolute highest tier fighters in the world with insane conditioning. And they're doing 5-minute rounds and they're exhausted. Every punch thrown makes you slower and weaker and makes you more out of breath. In combat, when you get out of breath, you die, because the enemy doesn't stop coming when you start to tire. Charlize gets fucking exhausted towards the end of the fight. She can barely keep her hands up, and she's slower to get back up when knocked down. She can't block hits as well, she can't hit back as hard, and she stumbles and can barely stand. At a point, our body just stops working. All you can think of is trying to get air, gasping for it. It feels like your body is being filled with concrete. If your enemy is fresh and you are fatigued, you're pretty much dead. Dying Light. Kyle Crane survived Haran, hugely due to his ridiculous level of conditioning. Some of the infected forms, like the volatiles that he's being chased by in this game, are very fast, agile, and can parkour too. I think it goes without saying that sustaining a flat-out sprinting pace while parkouring and hand-to-hand fighting roided-up predator zombies would require an unbelievable level of stamina that I don't think is fully appreciated. The problem, too, is that he has to run past new volatiles while being pursued by others, which means as he gets tired, he constantly encounters new volatiles that have full stamina. Realistically, you won't make it more than 400 yards in a flat-out sprint before you're fried. And if a new volatile spots you, it's game over. Even Usain Bolt needs to recover. Think of John Wick, some of the greatest action in recent years. But one thing is kind of missing. Exhaustion. There is no way John Wick could keep up the pace he does in the movie. We just talked about Atomic Blonde getting completely destroyed in 7 minutes. John Wick is running that pace for days without stopping much. Yes, they show him getting his ass kicked and he shows signs of getting tired and run down, but still. John Wick isn't just walking around shooting people. He's judo throwing people, knife fighting, fighting much larger opponents and martial artists. I mean, all three of the John Wick movies occur right after each other. Wick literally gets no break from fighting mobsters to hitmen to entire cities full of elite hitmen and special forces from shadow organizations. I mean, Jesus Christ, he killed 300 people over the three movies. 300. That's like the Tour de France of killing people, and he's not even doping. Not to mention, shooting requires concentration and fine motor skills and steady hands. You know, the things that rapidly deteriorate when you're fighting for your life for days and weeks with no sleep, killing hundreds of highly skilled attackers. After a couple rounds of hand-to-hand combat, it becomes hard to even hold your hands up to your face to block shots, let alone making precise pistol shots like he does. I mean, I could go on and on about the utterly insane Olympic-level recovery and conditioning you'd have to survive in that environment. It is as impressive as his shooting skills, in my opinion. I know these are movies and games and fictional, but it's something I definitely notice, and I think it's interesting. If you want me to talk about the psychological combat fatigue as it pertains to movies and games in another video, leave a like. And what other movies and games are a good example of characters either having unlimited supplies of stamina or are good depictions of how physically demanding combat is? Leave a comment down below. Thanks. Later.